Welcome to Clarkson Road at Presbyterian Church and this service of worship for the week of Sunday, March the 13th. This is our second week in Lent. I'm Gail McDonald, the minister, and it is my joy and honor to welcome you to this time of worship, and I'm so glad that we are able to join in from our homes as we are spread across this city and much further afield for this time of worship. Just one big announcement for you before we get into worship. Our session met on Tuesday evening and decided that we will be returning to the sanctuary, opening up the sanctuary again, starting on Sunday, March the 27th. Now, we are fully committed to offering a hybrid worship, and what that means is that we will be opening the sanctuary so that those who feel ready to do so and are able are welcome to come to worship in the sanctuary on Sunday mornings. It also means that we will be live streaming and recording our service, so those who aren't able to come to the sanctuary or don't feel comfortable yet coming back, that you are still able to worship. Now, many of you know that we are having some internet issues at the church, and when we were live streaming before, we'd get so far and not very far into the service when we would freeze and things would get awkward. So our tech team has been working to try and get us switched over to Rogers and have better service, and we are making some great progress towards that. But we aren't quite there yet, and so we are going to compromise. I think families do this all the time. We make compromises in decisions that it's just not what one person wants, but it's for the good of the entire family. And so we are going to adjust our worship time until we get the new internet service in to 9:30 on Sunday mornings. And so what that'll do is it'll allow us, we will live stream at that time, but it'll let us record the service as well. And then we'll run home and we'll upload the recorded service so those who are worshiping from their homes will actually have a better quality of service and they won't have to deal with all the interruptions. So you can watch your email. There's an email that goes out every Friday, and we'll put a lot more details closer to that date about what that's going to look like and how it will work. But we're quite excited to be able to reopen the sanctuary and have worship here Sunday mornings and to have some folks here. As we prepare to worship, invite you to just take a deep breath and center yourselves. If you have a candle in your space, this would be a great time to light it, and I'm going to light our Christ candle as we do every week, and lighting this candle gives us a visual reminder that Jesus came to be the light of the world and that Christ's light continues to shine in the world. It doesn't take much to just change things, and especially in dark places or times, that little bit of light changes the whole scene. And we are the ones that Jesus trusts to take his light into the world. As we continue our movement through this Lenten season, this week we are going to look at another opportunity to let go. This week, we lament that so much of life is really out of our control. This is frustrating to us, and so we've sometimes been tempted to believe what we hear. When we hear people tell us that if we just think positively, or we do this or that, we'll be able to turn everything around and everything will be as it was. Yet our experience in life has often shown us that it doesn't quite work that way. Not all the time, anyhow. We have surrounded ourselves today. We've got some plants up here to remind us that life is about nurturing what is, not always just what we hope for or what we're lamenting what was, but to nurture what is. So as you see these plants behind us for the rest of this Lenten season, I ask you to remember that they require some tending and some nurturing, and so do we. Our lives are good. Let's worship. To join me in the call to worship. There'll be slides on your screen, and you're welcome to join in those bolded lines. And together, we will do the call to worship and prayer that comes to us from Presbyterian World Service and Development, a mission arm of our national church. And they are, through ACT Alliance, on the ground near and in Ukraine to give out humanitarian aid. And certainly anyone who wishes, this is one of the organizations that you can donate to offer help, very tangible frontline help to those who are in Ukraine and the surrounding countries. During Lent, we remember God's justice is being established and the oppressed are set free. Let us submit our lives to Christ and be liberated from the patterns and sins that keep us captive. God's grace brings justice and is at work within us, encouraging our relationships and challenging the flawed systems we are part of. Sometimes change is gradual, and sometimes it happens quickly. All things are possible with God. Let us pray. Liberating God, you call us to seek that justice in the world which reflects the divine righteousness revealed within the Bible. When it is difficult to see your grace and justice at work, let us feel a strong sense of your presence and you at work in the world. Keep us focused on the one who is the way, the truth, and the life, Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. We come now to our prayer of adoration and confession. And the choir is going to come and be with us virtually, of course, throughout Lent, and we'll be singing the Lord's Prayer throughout the rest of this season. So let's come now with our prayers of adoration and confession. God, ever creating, ever loving, ever leading, when things around us feel chaotic and out of control, you are peace. When so much of what we hear is not reliable, your word is truth. When we are paralyzed by fear and anxiety, your presence is freedom. When we feel bereft and helpless, your love gives us hope. God, you are the source of all that matters. We bring you our prayers and our praise this day, for you reveal yourself to us in the goodness of creation, in the love and mercy of Christ, your beloved, and through the energy and wisdom of the Holy Spirit. We worship you, O God, ever three and ever one, world without end. God of compassion, we are creatures who seek out our own comfort. We let fear and anxiety take over when the uncontrollable happens in our lives. We confess that we prefer our own plans to your purposes. We shrink from costly discipleship and put our own interests first. We try to control what is uncontrollable. Forgive our fleeting commitment and the times that we have sought comfort and hope from the promises of the world rather than from your promises. Have mercy on us. Inspire us with the energy to do your will and serve our neighbors in the example of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Draw us closer to you so that we may know and experience the true source of hope. We ask this as we join with the choir now and singing the Lord's Prayer. Jesus got frustrated when people didn't behave as he would have liked. We probably aren't receiving death threats from Herod as Jesus was, but our well-being can be threatened by the ideas that if we just try hard enough, are nice enough, say just the right things, life will go our way. We run around in so many directions at times, trying to herd little chicks into some imagined semblance of perfect formation. Have you ever tried this? What if we could let go of needing all things and all people to be just so, and instead learn to dance with the unfolding of that which is not ours to control? Let us take a moment for silent reflection. Hear this compassionate word from the psalmist. I believe that I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and let your heart take courage. Wait for the Lord. Know that already God is offering us freedom from feeling alone in fixing what feels so wrong with this world, inviting us to let go of the need to be God, so that we might recognize that God is with us, offering courage in difficult and challenging times. And know that in spite of our sometimes faltering steps, in the name of Jesus Christ, you are being forgiven even now. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Our Lord is always with us, and when we recognize the Lord's closeness to us, it can be easier to go through those times and to face what it is that we can't control. Let us join Sarah now and sing together, like water to the thirsty.
As water to the thirsty, as beauty to the eyes, as strength that follows weakness, as truth instead of lies, as sometime and springtime and summertime to be, so is my Lord, my living Lord, so is my Lord to me. Like calm in place of clamor, like peace that follows pain, like meeting after parting, like sunshine after rain, like moonlight and starlight and sunlight on the sea, so is my Lord, my living Lord, so is my Lord to me. As sleep that follows fever, as gold instead of gray, as freedom after bondage, as sunrise to the day, as home to the traveler, and all we long to see, so is my Lord, my living Lord, so is my Lord to me.
Prayer for understanding. God of wisdom, your word brings light to show us the way you would have us follow. As the scriptures are read and proclaimed this day, send us your Holy Spirit to aid our understanding and to guide us in the ways we live out your truth. Amen. Psalm 27. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When evildoers assail me to devour my flesh, my adversaries and foes, they shall stumble and fall. Though an army encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war rise up against me, yet I will be confident. One thing I asked of the Lord, that will I seek after, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple. For he will hide me in his shelter in the day of trouble. He will conceal me under the cover of his tent. He will set me high on a rock. Now my head is lifted up above my enemies all around me, and I will offer in his tent sacrifices with shouts of joy. I will sing and make melody to the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry aloud. Be gracious to me and answer me. Come, my heart says, seek his face. Your face, Lord, do I seek. Do not hide your face from me. Do not turn your servant away in anger, you who have been my help. Do not cast me off. Do not forsake me, O God of my salvation. If my father and mother forsake me, the Lord will take me up. Teach me your way, O Lord, and lead me on a level path because of my enemies. Do not give me up to the will of my adversaries, for false witnesses have risen against me, and they are breathing out violence. I believe that I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. wait for the Lord. Be strong and let your heart take courage. Wait for the Lord. Our gospel reading is Luke chapter 13, verses 31 to 35. At that very hour, some Pharisees came and said to him, "Get away from here, for Herod wants to kill you." He said to them, "Go and tell that fox for me. Listen, I am casting out demons and performing cures today and tomorrow, and on the third day I finish my work. Yet today, tomorrow, and the next day, I must be on my way, because it is impossible for a prophet to be killed outside of Jerusalem. Jerusalem, the city that kills the prophets and stones those who are sent to it. How often have I desired to gather up your children together as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, and you were not willing. See, your house is left to you, and I tell you, you will not see me until the time comes when you say, 'Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.'" This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks very much, Megan, for coming in and reading the scriptures for us this evening. I speak to you in the name of the Creator, the Son, and the Spirit. It was 1 year ago, on March the 13th, that COVID really became, 2 years ago, I made a mistake. 2 years ago, on March the 13th, that COVID really became real for us. I remember it was a Friday, and I was gathered together with some of my preaching colleagues, and we were having a day to talk about preaching and planning for Lent and Holy Week. And I remember our conversation wondering if we would be able to worship in our sanctuaries that Sunday. By that point, we knew that we would be shut down at some point. We just didn't know when. It was the next day that Session and I made the decision that, in fact, we would not be able to meet in the sanctuary on Sunday, and so we did our first pivot of the pandemic. Overnight, Bruce and Stuart and I figured things out, and on Sunday, we had our very first Facebook Live worship series. This was the beginning of a couple of out-of-control years. The pandemic that we have been living through has taught even the most ardent control freaks that we can't control everything. And when we really think about our lives and what happens in the world, there is so much that is out of our control. Control is really almost an illusion, a delusion for us. Every single one of us has or will face things that are completely out of our control, an unexpected diagnosis, a job loss, a relationship that began with so much love and hope that crumbles, the death of a life partner, not getting into the university program that we had our hearts set on. We could go on and on, couldn't we, listing the things that happen in our lives that can set us off balance, that can just rock us, that leave us yearning for some control, sometimes even clamoring for control. As people of faith, when these things happen to us, our response is often one of leaning into our faith. We do this sooner or later. But what does it mean to lean into our faith, and what do we expect to happen when we do lean in? How we answer those questions will vary for each of us. For many people, leaning in will involve praying for healing or restoration of some sort in the situation. So often the prayer is about going back to the way things were, for things to work out the way that we want them to work out, because surely we know what is best, and God just needs to listen, right? We look to God to take control, oftentimes doing our will, but we do look to God to take control, and we yearn and we long for some real tangible evidence that this isn't out of control. God has got the steering wheel and is taking us right back to the way things were, or to a very, very good outcome. We may get some subtle or some not so subtle messages from different places that will tell us that if we just pray the right way, if we live the right way, if we do things just right, if I'm up every morning at 5:30 and I'm praying, I'm reading the Bible, I am spending my time in devotion, everything is going to work out just fine. God is going to answer my prayers the way I expect and want Him to answer. These kind of messages come to us from many, many different places, and we probably get more of them because of social media. They're linked to what is often referred to as the prosperity gospel. Even though we aren't part of a church congregation, a community of faith that believes exactly those things, we get drawn into them. I am a wholehearted believer in prayer, and I do believe that prayer makes a difference, and that healings and restorations do happen, and that God is part of what happens. But I am not someone who believes that God is like a genie in a bottle. Just follow the right formula, do the right thing, say the right things, and God is waiting to just bless me and you and turn things back and give us the great outcome, all the desires of our hearts. We know that sometimes that's just not how things work out. Our triune God wants relationship with us more than anything. And so when things are out of control, we pray. We pray for healing and restoration, but we also open ourselves to God and we listen. Communication two ways. When we only tell God what we want and expect, we might miss out on the gifts that come to us. And they do come to us in the midst of our out-of-controlness. Healing from God's perspective and God's answer to our prayers might look very different from what we are expecting. As we know, our prayers aren't always answered in the time or the way that we are so desperate for them to be answered. And there are gifts in it. Meaning can come from suffering that we face, suffering that we certainly didn't want or ask for. And for this, we need an openness to God rather than imposing our expectations on God. Author Kate Bowler, whose Lent devotion we are using this year, has a brilliant podcast with author John Green. And I listened to it this week, and there was a brilliant line in it. He said that our lives are like a painting. We don't get to choose all the details of the painting, but what we do get to choose is how we frame the painting. We get to choose how we respond. Jesus helps us to pick the frame for those things that are out of control that happen in our lives. There is room in our pictures for suffering. And it doesn't mean that there aren't gifts in it. There is room for not being perfect. There is room for our perspectives to be changed so that we might see ourselves and others through different lenses. In our gospel reading from Luke, Jesus is getting closer to Jerusalem, closer to the point where he will be tried and crucified. We've heard Megan read to us that the Pharisees are trying to get him out of town, trying to tell him to leave, and he's not listening. Now, they're not likely saying get out of town for his own protection. It's probably more about them that they're saying this. He has become a problem, and so they really just want to get rid of him, get the problem out of the way. But Jesus isn't going anywhere. He is on a mission, and he's going after it with laser focus. Jesus was resolved to be the true prophet of God, to take on the role of the suffering servant for the world. He was resolved that his death was coming and would not be avoided. And yet, his words are the kind of words that come from someone who knows that they are ultimately safe. And what Jesus does in this passage and through the rest of what leads us to Holy Week and Good Friday and Easter Sunday is done to make us safe, to gather us to him as a hen gathers her brood of chicks. Gather us under his wings. That's such a comforting and beautiful scene and image. The one whose resurrected body bears crucifixion wounds draws us to him when things are out of control. He gathers us in when we are seeking healing and restoration. As Jesus gathers us in, he takes us to a safe spot, even though everything might feel so out of control. This is one of those huge, huge topics about how we understand God, where is God in suffering, how we understand our role, how we are changed, where is the goodness of God in suffering. So, so much. We could go on for weeks on this topic. Consider this your appetizer, and may it give you some great conversations. Happy to have those with you. I want to leave you with one thought to consider. In the dance of life, is it possible to think of the divine as our dance partner, who is dancing along with us through the really joyful, wonderful times, through the times when it maybe feels like a real tango, when things aren't so good, when things feel out of control. Is it possible to think about the divine with us through all of those things, inviting us in to be cared for, to be safe, offering us protection? How does that sit with you? Part of responding to the out-of-controlness of our life is surrendering to God. And we're going to join Sarah in singing Lord of All Power and sing of surrendering our wills, our hearts, and our minds to God so that we can let God speak into our lives. Let's sing. As we come to our time of offering, I want to just let you know that this past week, Compass moved into their new location and they began serving clients from their new location that is part of the Indwell building there on the bottom floor there. In your weekly email, there were some details about the Compass move and how to and when to drop off food if you are so inclined to do so. I also provided a link in that email to some job opportunities at Indwell. There are a number of them, and so I invite you to take a look at those, and if there are people that you know that might be interested, please pass them along, and we will continue to support Compass and Indwell through our work here. Let's pray a prayer of dedication now for all of our gifts. Wondrous God, we thank you for all that have been involved in getting Compass moved into their new location. We pray your blessing upon all that will be done there, that the many who will be served in your name will feel blessed and know that all that is done there is done because we are loving our neighbors. We are following you and being your hands and feet. Enable Compass to be a beacon of light and continue to show love for all those who are in need of their services. Lord, we thank you for the many ways that people give of their time, talent, and resources to support the ministry and mission to which you have called this community of faith. Bless all our gifts that we give joyfully because you first give to us. We give in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, as we come to our prayers of the people, I want to just remind you that we actually record this service late on Thursday. And so with everything that is happening in the world, I think it's just mindful of that. I've crafted this prayer so there will be time for us to pray silently so that we can respond to whatever is happening more immediately in Ukraine and the surrounding areas. I invite you now to join me in a time of prayer. Ever-present God, we are so grateful that you are with us every day. It really doesn't matter what's happening in our lives, you are there. We ask that you would help us to be aware of your compassionate presence, especially in those times when life feels out of control. And we thank you for the peace that you offer us. Oh, how amazing it is to feel your peace, that sense of calm come over us and into us when we are suffering and going through challenging times. Jesus, we lift up to you those who are dealing with challenging situations that very well might feel out of control. We pray for those who are looking for work, those who are in relationships that are broken or fractured, those who are lonely and grieving, and those who are dealing with health challenges. Continue to be with Andrew and his family, those who are recovering from COVID, in fact, all who are dealing with illness and all who are waiting to access health services. So much of our world feels out of control, Lord, and we feel helpless, worried, and scared at different times and to different degrees. Almighty God, we lift up to you the situation in Ukraine. We can't get the images of people fleeing their homes, being separated from loved ones, buildings and streets being blown apart. These images stick in our minds. Those standing firm to protect. In the silence, we pray for all the innocent people whose lives have been uprooted, whose lives are filled with turmoil. Hear our silent prayers now. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. God of justice, we pray for all who are standing up to defend their country. We pray for those whose previous trauma from the complicated history of Ukraine. We pray for those who are being triggered again. In the silence, we offer to you the prayers of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. And we pray for world leaders, We pray for President Zelensky and all the other leaders in Europe, the United States, Canada. This is not just a Russian-Ukraine situation. We pray for all others who are working to find a way toward a ceasefire and peace. And Lord, you challenge us to pray for those whom we don't agree with, we don't appreciate, or we just don't agree with what they're doing. And so we need to pray for President Putin. We are going to offer all our prayers now in the silence. We offer all these spoken and silent prayers to you in the precious name of Jesus. Amen. As we prepare to go from this time of worship, we're going to sing, "Take My Life and Let It Be Consecrated, Lord, to Thee." Blessing for when we realize that everyone is struggling, and this is written by Kate Boulder. Blessed are you who sees things clearly, where struggle is everyone's normal. You walk among the fellowship of the afflicted, a club no one wants to join. And while this life isn't shiny, it does come with superpowers. Superpowers of ever-widening empathy and existential courage that gets you back up after another fall, and a deepened awe at the beauty and love that can be found amid life's rubbles. Like flowers that grow from the cracks in the sidewalk, these virtues blossom in you, and thank God for you. Blessed are all of us who struggle, for we are in good company, and we will never walk alone. And now may the God who loves all of creation, especially when it's painful, and Jesus, our companion along this crooked path called life, and the Holy Spirit who loves to improvise in surprising ways, go with you, dwell among you, and give you joy. Amen.
Turn the light off, go to bed, tell him all about the day you've had, lay beside me, it's time to rest, you can close your eyes, you've done your best, let him be. Sanctuary. He will share.